Eric in the red gloves with black shorts, and here we go, round number one of this three-minute round event. Eric comes across with a couple. I think he's out to show, and Sharon's in the building. He's coming after him.
Yeah, hopefully Sharon's watching this fight. Definitely taking notice.
Oh, good knee to the face.
Good clinch work from Eric. Good underhook, post on the head.
This will be the problem that I see when he's fighting Sharon, is the space. Sharon doesn't let you get into this type of situation.
No, his range, Sharon's really good with his range. His hands are quick. Definitely, and also very physically athletic and strong. I don't see how Eric can make it too much trouble for him.
Both fighters still standing up in the red corner. Eric's still very much the aggressor here.
Eric pushing the pace, getting the takedown, passing the guard right away. Nick, with Dave Reeves, his corner, right next to him, telling him what to do. I think one of Nick's strengths will be his jiu-jitsu, but we'll have to see about how Eric deals with it.
Last couple of fights, when you've seen Eric down on the ground, his ground game, as a matter of fact, I can't remember the last time I saw Eric on the ground. He usually comes out and just pounds somebody.
Yeah, I think I'm in agreement with that. I don't think I've ever actually seen him on the ground.
But, you know, he's got him in a little half guard here, and his little ground and pound is working. So, you know, those little blows that we talk about this all the time, Reed, the little blows to the face that you think are not hurting, they are hurting.
Yeah, especially if they had up quick, especially hitting you. A couple times you catch in the eye or, just in the right spot where it just can be miserable being on bottom. Right now, Eric working to the back. Nick trying to bridge out of it, giving Eric his back. Eric with the arm around the neck, working the choke.
Being in this situation as the bottom fighter. Uh-oh, Eric's got him.
One thing Nick wants to do is try to clear the hooks. Eric's got his hooks in on the inner thigh, controlling, keeping him from rolling one way or the other. Nick's got to try a couple strikes from behind, aren't mainly what he wants to go for, but it can't help get some space. Eric tightening up the choke. Nick with his chin down, trying to 2-on-1, pop that elbow up, try to strip the arm off.
Really trying to stop this rear naked choke from happening from Eric, and I just don't think he's got it right here. I don't think he has it under his chin.
No, he doesn't have the chin. Nick's got his chin tucked. He's holding onto the arms.
Eric pretty strong by just reopening the hands of Kronstadt. With about 10 seconds left to go in round number one, I still have to give the aggressor for this round to Eric right off the bat.
Eric's definitely controlled the fight from the first all the way to the last second of this round.
Ben Moore stops the fight right there as you hear the horn for round number one. Let's go. As you get over to the corner here, what are you going to be able to tell Nick Mansburger? What are you going to tell him and say, hey, how are we going to beat this guy? Because right now, the dominant fighter right now is Eric Kronstadt.
I think Nick has to come out, keep the space if he wants to keep striking. But if he wants to go to the ground, he needs to get on top. Or if he gets taken down, definitely needs to get back to his guard. If you give Eric the top, he's really aggressive, he's good transitions. Nick needs to try and slow that down as best he can.
See a little blood coming from the crown right on the top of Nick Mansburger's nose. Mansburger is really going to start to bleed if Eric can catch that a couple more times. Ooh. Morris has the corners out of the ring. And here we go with round number two. Just the concentration that you see with Eric Kronstadt, the look in his eye right now. It's just like he's so focused. A little blood still on the face here of Nick Mansburger.
Ready, ready? Ready? Fight!
Dave Moore gives a call for round number two.
Nick not afraid to come out, coming out hard. Nice. Nice combo from Nick Mansburger as they slam into our side of the cage. Nick pushing the pace a little more than he did last round. Eric against the cage. Eric trying to work for the single leg.
Might have been Nick's strategy the whole time, just to get through round number one and then try to exert some energy here in rounds two and three. Now we see some blood coming from the left eye of Kronstadt. Looks like he got caught.
Yeah, he that hook straight combo from the beginning at least that number two after the hook definitely landed as they first came out.
And now there's a lot of blood on both fighters. And we talked about this in the last fight. We talked about some people are bleeders and some people aren't.
Oh, I mean, some people have tough skin. Sometimes the glove is just that thick and makes it hard to, cut someone with those.
I mean, now we're talking about some major blood all over both fighters. And at some point in time, does Dave Morris need to stop this and get both these fighters cleaned up, or can he let them go?
He can keep them going, especially if there's a bad cut. But right now, Nick caught in a bad triangle. Eric's got a nice triangle.
He's got
the tap. Eric, victory by triangle choke.
Eric Kronstadt catches Nick in a bad position there in round number two. Eric Kronstadt, the winner by tap.
Submission triangle choke. The red corner, Eric Kronstadt. And while we're up here, could we please get Sharon Thompson up to the circle right now?